Tonight's Mailbag Monday starts with a ceremonial pouring of the beer. This time it is Cheeky Bastard Stout from Nickelbrock Brewing in Burlington, Ontario. They describe it as a twist on a traditional British stout, combining a rich roasted body with smooth, sweet finish, low in ABV, and high in deliciousness. Oh yeah, that's the stuff right there. I like a beer with a good head on it too, except for it kind of gets in my mustache, but it lets me savor the flavor for later. First item in has no... Oh, it says one times chip. Okay. Let's see what we have. Oh! It is one of those driverless LED cob kind of things. I ordered a bunch of those a year or more ago. Let me just go and check the listing and find out what this guy is. Full spectrum LED grows light LED cob chip for hydroponic greenhouse plant. Got this from BGU4443. Currently going for $2.04 American or $2.68 Canadian. I paid, it was $2.04 when I bought it as well, but the dollar was in a little bit worse, actually a little bit better shape, and I paid $2.66 Canadian back then. However, it was free shipping back then. Of course, nothing is at the moment. They have a few different versions, all the way from 20 watts up to 70 watts. How much does that 70 watt one cost? A fair bit more. Anyway, I got the 110 volt version. You could buy a 220 volt version if your country prefers that. High quality aluminum shell, blah, 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 blah. Yeah, whatever. Lifespan, 50,000 hours. Luminous flux, 80 to 90 lumens per watt for a 20 watt bulb lamp. Okay. 120 degree beam width, 380 to 840 color temperature. Probably more like nanometers. Color temperatures in a very different sort of format. Up to 50,000 hours. Yeah. Okay. Let's go and tinker with this just a little bit here. So I'll just solder up a line cord onto this thing. The hardest part about soldering onto these aluminum PCBs is that they suck the heat away, which is exactly what they're designed to do. So to give myself the best chances, I've got the large tip on my iron because it's got the most thermal mass on it. And I think I will use my SMD rework tool to just preheat the thing so that I stand some kind of a chance. And as you can see, I've got a little silicone thing down here on my cutting mat so I don't burn my cutting mat. And let's try that now. Yeah, that works better. But that heat goes away quickly. I think that'll work. So just for precautions, I've stuck the thing onto just a random heat sink here, just with some capped on tape. I've got my ammeter in there. Now we'll deal with that in a second. So, contact. That is showing 460 milliamps. That is ridiculously bright. Man, can you even see that? Here, let me try and dim it for you a little bit. Does that help? A little bit, maybe. So how are we doing for heat here? My heat sink's doing its job. That's good. Not sure if you can see the color of that. Let's I'll just shine it onto some white paper so you can get an idea of what the color of it is. To me, it looks a little bit sort of like a warm pinky blue. Of course, as I've said many, many times, I am horribly colorblind, so it could be anything really. If you've got better eyes than I do, let me know down in the comments. But to me, it looks sort of like grow lights that I've seen in the past. And so do the spots in my eyes. Okay, clean this up and continue on with the next mailbag item. Next thing in is connecting line, it says. That is a cable. It is, looks like it's a USB on the go cable. Hey, that's what I need for the Raspberry Pi on my printer. Oh, cool. So USB on the go basically allows a device like a phone or something to act as a host for any standard USB devices. Or if your computer, like a Raspberry Pi, only has a USB mini or a USB-C on it, then this can also be used just to break it out. It's one of those nice braided cables too. There's nothing ultimately special about a USB on the go cable. It's just wired straight through, positive, negative voltage, D plus, D minus, straight through. On the device side, there is one extra pin that gets grounded to indicate to the phone or tablet or whatever that it should act as a USB host instead of its normal operation as a USB device. 2-in-1 USB 3 OTG cables, Type-C micro to USB 3 adapter for Huawei, Samsung, and pretty much every other brand of phone, but whatever, they got to get their keywords in there someplace. I got this from Randika, 1995, a relatively new seller, doesn't sell very much stuff. I got it at auction for $1.64 Canadian or $1.25 American, and I did pay 64 cents shipping. I figured that was reasonable for something like this. Their normal retail price is $5.24 Canadian, so seemed like a bit of a deal. Not much to say about it down here in the specs. 17 centimeters long. Yeah, that's about right. They're really playing up this braided cable thing. All right, next in we have connector times 10. Maybe. It is connectors. Oh, those are XT60 connectors. So these XT60 connectors are the connector that is used on large capacity LiPo packs, typically for remote control vehicles and things, but not exclusively. I've seen 3D printers use them. They're basically just a high current polarized connector. Solder a good size wire onto there. I would say you'd probably be able to get 16 gauge, maybe 14 gauge onto it, which means you'd be able to haul, you know, tens of amps through it easily. And they seem to go together fairly smoothly. Now then, I have no illusions that these are the highest quality ones, because as usual, I bought them from the cheapest Chinese seller. But as long as I don't overload them or overstress them, they should be fine. So the male pins have a little split in them, and they're using that as a sort of a spring for tension on them. The female side is just a simple cylinder. Got the polarity marked up there on that end. That's negative. That's positive. Huh, those could come in handy for DC power connections on various projects. 10 pairs XT60 female male bullet connectors for RC battery L5H1, which means nothing to me. For RC battery connectors is their normal use. Got these from Goodwill_Elfie. I did pay $4.72 Canadian with free shipping. There is nothing else to say about them down here. I guess if you're going to look for specifications on something that's used in RC, you might as well look at a RC site. This is Hobby King, and they are saying that XT60s are good for applications up to and beyond 65 amps of constant current. Wow. Next in, we have, what does it say here? Screw times one. I hope there's more than one screw in that. It's not screws at all. This is female header pins, and it looks like I've got two different kinds. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, it looks like I've got 7 pin versions and 8 pin versions, and 10 of each. And the reason that I got these is I got tired of cutting down the long ones to the exact length that I needed. You can get them in 40 pin lengths, which I have some in my drawer of headers here. That's the length that they normally come in. But I was finding that I needed some shorter ones. And actually, are they the ones that match up with D1 minis and D1 mini shields? Yes, the 8-pin ones are. Okay. Cool. So then why did I also order the 7-pin ones? Presumably I've got something that needs 7-pin versions. Yeah, and the D1 mini kits actually come with these as well, just the longer versions. I just wanted some short ones.
2.54mm single row straight copper pin female header 1x2/3/4/5/6/7/8 10p to 20p 40p. Okay.
Yeah.
So I got 10 7 pin and 10 8 pin. This came from Superior Buy 2014. $1.98 Canadian for the 7 pins and $204 Canadian for the 8 pins. And they did charge me shipping, but they only charged me one shipping fee, not shipping on both of them. So that was nice of them. And it was 66 cents Canadian or 50 American pennies.
And the final thing, which is something that I have absolutely no idea what's in there. This was sent to my P.O. box by Patrick in Quebec. Merci, Patrick. Let's see what we've got here. Oh, there's a note. And actually, let's check the note first. The note says, "Greetings from Quebec, a simple jewel thief kit that he offers. Hard to believe it's actually from Canada, not China." And it really did come from Quebec, too. Oh, wait. From his own store. He's actually selling these on eBay. Oh, I'll have to go and check that out. Anyway, here is the actual kit. Oh, wow. I'm going to have to take a look at this guy. It's got instructions in it too. Nice. Got so a 3D printed battery holder. And another 3D printed battery holder with a magnet on it. Or something metal. Yep, that works. What, do you expect me to use anything else to test a magnet? So we got the battery holder, on-off switch. We have a little transformer, which you expect to find in a jewel thief. We have four LEDs, those kind of bluish white ones. They all the same? Yep. Yeah, okay. A transistor. Oh, five LEDs. No, four. One transistor, one resistor, a couple of bits of wire, a circuit board, and a wooden stick. So this calls itself a low-power E-light. Actually, that is that a transistor or is that one of those specialized little chips? 2N3904, that is just a transistor. NPN, I think. Yep, just a standard NPN transistor. Okay. So this is actually the classic jewel thief circuit, the one that Big Clive has his name on. Dare I look at the instructions now, or should I save that for when I build the kit? Oh, that's what the wooden stick's for winding your own inductor. Oh, neat. Okay. Even use the bits of wire through the holes in the 3D printed battery holder to make your own battery clips. Very cool. Well, Patrick, I'm going to have fun building this kit sometime in the future. I've got several kits piling up. Wow. Yeah, probably. I'm thinking maybe near the end of the year, just doing a few weeks worth of kit builds. I don't know. What do you guys think? Let me know in the comments. Anyways, yeah, this should be a slick little one to put together.
It's always good to find a Canadian seller on eBay. Let's just see what Patrick has in his store here. There's our jewel thief kit with swivel fridge magnets. And there it is, all lit up and working. Cool. So there's that inductor that you have to wind yourself.
That's kind of old school. I like that. Ah, okay. There's how it works. The battery clip goes onto the board, and that small one with the magnet goes onto the battery to hold it to your fridge. Right, it says it's a fridge magnet, doesn't it? What else has he got, just for the fun of it here? Some gas fireplace stuff, motor controllers, amplifiers, pipe clamps, stepper motors. Oh, with the lead screw on the front end. That's kind of neat. More stepper motors. Looks like a neat little store. I'm going to have to browse around here a little bit in the future. And here is the contents of today's Mailbag Monday haul. Quite a variety and a neat surprise from Patrick. That's very nice of him. So, shipping times, just quickly. The 20-watt grow light took 44 days. The USB on-the-go adapter took 32 days. The bag of XT60s took 44 days. And the winner, or loser, is these pin headers, which took 105 days to get here from China. Ordered them way back in May, and they showed up here in August. Wow. Anyway, thanks for watching. Thank you very much to my Patreon supporters for helping me keep the mailbags rolling in. Thanks to Patrick for sending me this little Joule Thief kit. That's very neat. And yeah, thanks for watching. Comments and questions down below as usual. I'll talk to you later.